We loved denim in the 70s. We couldn't get enough of it. But in 1979, things suddenly changed. Jeans got rich, and designer labels began.
From New York City, home of America's most famous monuments, most famous landmarks, most famous skyscrapers, come America's most famous designer jeans. Jeans?
Yes, jeans. Hello. I'm Gloria Vanderbilt, and I design America's best-selling designer jeans, right here in New York.
Nobody had heard of Gloria Vanderbilt, except she had this millionaire surname. So they were kind of millionaire jeans.
What kind of jeans have you got?
Dazzling colors and flattering styles that shape your waist, hug your hips, don't gap here.
I don't know what kind of woman she designed those jeans for, but I wasn't one of them.
They're the tops. They're the upper stratas. They're the jeans with the social status.
I mean, at the time, we were still sort of scraping up pocket money to buy a pair of jeans for a fiver from the market. So things like designer jeans were so out of our league.
We're chauffeured caddies. They're for girls blessed with wealth.
If you didn't have the cash for Gloria's jeans, then you'd better have a good figure. Jeans were about to go really tight.
I remember like stretch denim being this thing where it was kind of, you know, like a new discovery that was going to change people's lives and help people. You know, it had a kind of a medicinal value to it.
The stretch denim indigo jeans, the most unattractive jeans of all time.
You had to have long legs, small hips and a pert bum.
No matter how big your bum was, no matter how wide your thighs were, no matter how skinny they were, it just didn't matter.
Because what you'd do is buy not one size too small, but at least two sizes too small.
And things bulged out all over, you know, there were the big bits of thigh sticking out there and, you know, bits of bum sticking out here.
And then you kind of zip the whole thing up, trying not to get any skin in it, sucking everything in as much as you possibly could.
You were like sealed in. It was fantastic. And they were drain piped as well, so they did give the illusion of a slightly long leg.
And then, of course, you couldn't stand up.
They were so tight, I used to walk in a very strange way, with very small steps.
And the one thing you didn't want to do while you were out is go to the toilet. Because the idea of getting stuck in the toilet and not being able to get your jeans back on was the most horrific nightmare ever. When girls wore them, it was bad enough. But when boys wore them, they may as well have been naked. A 17-year-old boy in a pair of stretch naked jeans wasn't good. It's just, it was all there. What can I say?
Romantic lady, single baby.